Hi, it's your girl Timbo.
It's your boy Ty.
And this is Under the Influence. Chilling, you know. Just got done getting under the influence.
Yeah, we chilling, man. Got my boy Eric behind the cam, you know what I'm saying? Easy Visions. You
know. Shout out.
Trying to get the shoot, you know what I'm saying? Hit us up.
At Easy Visions. On IG.
.com. You should make it a .com. That'd be nice.
You can follow me on IG. Tyron Hinton. TYRONHENTON. You can follow me. Yeah, fuck with me.
You can follow me, Queen Timberly. QUEENTIMBERBERLY _. That's my Instagram. I'm just saying all my exes. I'm just mixing all my exes.
Yeah.
But the winner got a lot of necklaces.
No. What about XXX and Toxic? What about the guy? The guy XXX, I'm beyond it, I don't know how to say his name. I always say extension cord.
Extension. Really?
But that's not his name.
That's how you say it? No, that's not how you spell extension.
The dude X. Y'all think he did? Y'all suspicious about it?
I don't know. That is very suspicious. Everything that went down is very suspicious. And then just seeing how people were reacting to it as well was even more suspicious. I think to me that's the thing that raised the most suspicion, was how people reacted to him being dead. Like, the fact that, yes, people called the ambulance, but more people recorded him than actually checked on him to see if he was okay. That's concerning. Like, maybe he really was okay the whole time. They knew what they were doing. They knew that they were involved with the shit. You know what I mean? To get that shit publicized. Like,
the way that he would, like, record and, like, let everybody know, like, if you will die and shit, like, yeah. So, that shit, I don't believe it did, so. I just don't.
Any normal human being would not have reacted like that in a situation. If you, me being a normal human being, and I'm not very normal, I know I'm weird, but, like, the humanity in me would not have been able to just sit by and record somebody just being shot and killed. Like, that's crazy. You're definitely gonna go see if he still has a pulse, because what if you can still save this man's life, but instead you're recording it? What sense does that make?
Yeah, like,
why not say
see him? Nah, yeah, like, you're gonna call somebody. Now she's gonna, like,
just seem like it was all just set up. You may have fooled a lot, but you know. If he does pop up dead, it's only because so many people talk shit. And too many people figured it out too soon. You have to understand what they're trying to convince you. I mean, not convince you, but distract you from. Why did this nigga just have to pop up dead out of nowhere? And we don't have any, like, real proof that he's dead, except for the media telling us that he's dead.
At 20.
I mean, it was reported on CNN, but then I understand y'all saying, like, okay, like, why ain't nothing just going on? Same thing happened with Tupac.
True.
Like, can't nobody confirm it? Like, everybody feel like it can't be confirmed because tattoos weren't matching up and nothing like that.
But there's a lot of assassinations that go on that are either pinned on somebody else or the sketchiest of sketchy, just because of what they represented within history.
Yeah, well, why do you feel like it's an assassination on X?
Not necessarily an assassination on him. I'm talking about, like, other people that we were talking about in that context. With him, some say that it could be sacrificial. Some say that it could just be him trying to build himself up more. So, I mean, you can all speculate, but at the end of the day,
Stop rapping, but, like, still making money and, like, spending money.
I mean, because, like you said earlier, look at how high his sales got. Or look how many streams he got on all of his songs since he's died. He wanted to see if people really gave a fuck. Do we give a fuck?
In my eyes, I don't feel like they give a fuck because, like Biggie said, people gonna love you more when you're gone. When Biggie died, he got more album sales. It probably wasn't as many as when he was alive, but his album sales rose. Tupac, same thing. When anybody died, people will fuck with their music more. Mm-hmm. Just because they're dead. But then the next month or the week after that, anybody fuck with his music no more.
Yeah.
Like Lil Snoop. When Lil Snoop got killed, everybody bumped his music, bumped his music, bumped his music. Nobody listened to Lil Snoop like that no more.
Because he's not a reoccurring actor. I mean, rapper anymore. I said actor. Whoops.
I feel like, I mean, I don't, some might care, but I feel like all of them don't.
Which is true. Unless you were already like a living legend before then. Like Tupac or Biggie.
See, like, my thing is, I never listened to none of X music or nothing like that. Mm-hmm. Haven't heard any songs like
Nobody that. Really. It's like, he directed his platform to a different age group. And it was like, within our age group, it was a hit or miss. Some people really like that rap. I don't know how to say his name, so I don't even want to get it wrong. Some people really like him, though, in our age group. And then other people are just like... And we tend to be more of one of those people that don't really listen to it. But he also was a different type of rapper.
Yeah, like, I don't think I knew about him was like what was in the media. Of him trying to fight people all the time and talking about trying to beef with everybody. And the recent thing with... his baby mama or ex-girlfriend, whatever, with the domestic violence, that's all that I've heard about him.
Mm-hmm. That's the most thing anybody's heard about him, is all the things that he's done bad and trying to justify that's why he should have died. And it's just like, you should not wish that upon anybody. I mean, who are you to judge? You know what I mean? I'm pretty sure you've done fucked up shit in your life. I'm pretty sure you've done some shit that somebody would want to kill you for. Like, and if you haven't, I know you're not all peachy clean, you know what I mean? But still, like, this is a kid, you know what I mean? He still had some type of redemption somewhere. Even if we did still label him as what he was, he still had some type of redemption to try to do something good. And from what it looks like, he was trying to do a lot of good. And that's why they killed him off.
I feel that.
Trying to destroy what he was building.
So, I played y'all that Kanye West, it's called Live Your Life. You know, the Scoop Deep, Scooby Doo. Mm-hmm. Okay, so, see, the first time when I listened to it, I mean, I'm not a huge Kanye fan, but I fuck with Kanye.
I love Kanye.
It's just his recent shit, I don't fuck with it.
I don't know what that was. But, I've never heard that before, and I was very
confused. Well, my list of songs, like, all right, so, you know, maybe Kanye's gonna address, you know, why he's been missing, the breakdown, whatever, blah, blah, blah. And then he come out with that, and I was like, that was a waste of 2 minutes and 38 seconds. I could have been playing a game, drinking some Henny that you see right there. No, we're not sponsored.
Mm-hmm. Not sponsored.
Drinking some water or doing something else productive, like editing photos, Instagram and bio. But, I mean, I listened to that and I was disappointed. How do y'all feel about that?
I was disappointed. I was not expecting, like... not expecting something like that at all. Not at all. It was...
I don't listen to Kanye.
I love Kanye. Kanye back in the day was a very, very, very influential rapper. And it's crazy because I didn't like Kanye back in the day. Because back in the day, I wasn't very open-minded. I was very closed-minded. And then it wasn't until I started getting older that I really started appreciating Kanye and understanding what Kanye was talking about and trying to tell me. And then... from there, I just dug deeper. I mean, there was a lot of people musically that played parts in the discovery of life. If that makes